Okay,
그래서
ready.
오야 땅 아로 소테니 치루 넘바스 테니 사주 소소소소 류바 카발 요바 이나요 테니 다 드리고 간데 네 스테이지 데 시작이요 스테니 텔라 텐디라 테니라 테니 마세키 워도 마세 레레 노타 레와 쳔모치요스
So first of all, Geshe-la would like to greet all of his Dharma friends, whichever country you find yourselves in, wherever you are. And he is going to explain a little bit of the teaching, and his hope is that on this basis, you can have a happy life and you can have a relaxed life.
아니 저도 타니 야 간도 강가로 코알 데야 이사 코알 타니 네스 넘만다 요가도 두가 네스 몸보지 요아르 테니 이나요 소소로 자 치슈 나 나이 리 나이 셈세 데서 다할레 가치모 자 치모 니바치모 시레 데와레스
So then, of course, generally all of us are in this situation of samsara or cyclic existence. And so we will encounter problems, we will encounter difficulties. But it's important to remember that in terms of us who are within samsara, that we call the self and my body and my mind, these are very significant things. They have tremendous potential.
오다 대지 잘라 자 첨부도 가 첨부 니밤모 지야 이자 아니 가로서 모두 돈을 쓰러 이기나요 아니 대시 땜보지도 벌써 수바지 그와 누지 오다 대지 땜데 더 토요아래 소소소소래래 치나
And on the basis of all of this, that we call the self, my body, and my mind, if we do the work, if we engage in the correct kind of activities, then we will be able to discover something. What? That stable happiness that all beings, both humans and animals, seek. We will be able to achieve that.
오다 가 첨부 들으니 대시 돼야 되라 아니 나로서 아니 가르스 가다 소설 디세 데 디세 남만다 셔도 몸보지 요아르 되는 소설로 고가 요아슈 디세 요아슈 제 요아슈 데 다디 디세를 이 소마데 모시바 제토나 다이 계속 첨부지로 하여 하레스
And there's another thing that we can do to come to great benefit, to great profit for ourselves. It's if we think about all of the various different times and so forth, we have to realize that the time, in order to be able to transform, in order to have the very best opportunity, that time is in fact right now. If we can recognize this, it is very helpful.
오다 단단가 로서 어느 통 대학에서 남은 두고 대학에 갔더니 어느 시부터 막 손주도 손주에서 막 뭐뭐 지요하래 그러 소용가 로서 뭐 지금 물이 아픈 데리 지라 대라 때네 다 거가 여셔 다리 소미토네 내가 때 무슨 것 주토가 이자 그러스가 니나 기고 저에 어느 거가 지라 바레스
And in terms of those things that we are seeing and hearing today, these Buddhas and the Bodhisattvas, it's important to understand that in the beginning they were exactly like us. These Buddhas and Bodhisattvas, they were exactly like us. But in terms of finding these different conditions, gondada jangchu gisamba dangsangye kandida boredina?
Sigiyos koros koka shimbo jira bares, tungko tani chichu toba yita.
And of these Buddhas and Bodhisattvas in the beginning, they were just like us, but having realized the precious opportunity they had, they were able to activate it, to make it useful.
Ota ngaro soyo tani tati ka yabo chi lele chine toche cheba yina, koka ngine koka shimbo chi yuares, ota koka di ngiso tona.
So if in a relaxed way we check, we really look at our situation, we will realize that we have this very valuable opportunity, this opportunity that we must recognize.
Deswa, ota shato kowala dewa isa pache dhavo to nyodan dhavo mumbo shi yuari tene ina yon teji chuchulun go kwa dewa ina ane cher cher dhoan dhavo chi do tene temo dhavo chi nwa shani la marasur pache mumbo te yuaris.
So of course we are all within the state of samsara in cyclic existence. We will encounter these problems and difficulties, but if we obsess over, if we grasp at those problems, not only will we not solve them, but in fact we will just obsess over them and those problems will become more frequent and they will get bigger and bigger. There's no benefit to that.
오다가 제주 대세 넘는데 다 어느서 간지스레 잘라봐 이는 땅 아래서 매요조 모두 돈도 쓰이나요 대시 퍼서 봐서 노는 데봐 요아래 강에 제주 간지스이나요 뭐가 근데 봐지 요아래스
So then, all of us, whether humans or animals, what do we share? We all share this wish to achieve every happiness, a perfect and lasting happiness. And similarly, all of us beings share this wish to be able to get rid of all problems or sufferings.
어다 나로 솔로 어다 녀서 든지 그바 노지 든지기 대시 때 몸보치기 시지에라 되네 대학 다시 또 요하르 되네 땡아조 시지에 다 대시 대야 요도 요하르 왔어 이나요 대 조마레스
So, of course, many of us, we are all seeking this happiness as was stated, and many of us think that we can secure that happiness, we can find that happiness by focusing on outer conditions, by looking for outer conditions or causes of that happiness outside ourselves. And so we understand that yes, outer factors can give some small, fleeting happiness, but in terms of this lasting happiness, it is not something that comes from outside.
어다 대시 그 조대 센지 대시 이제 센지 대시 돼야 돼세 노노는 시절을 걸어보게 세 옆에 있던 시연을 돼야지 레마도 시제 주보가 어다들은 돼야 말이야.
And we understand that really, out of the different types of happiness, the most important type of happiness is mental happiness. And then, of course, that mental happiness must come from the mind. And if we want to have that mental happiness in the mind, then we need to give rise to those good things within the mind, those internal conditions, right? That mental happiness is not going to come from things outside.
어다 대 시에게야 오지 세 쪼가르제 세 노노는 세세세 요가르지 세 이제 대시에 들어가야 돼 나로서 강에 되게 이나요 몸보지 그 실로라 손은 몸보도 요아르 때쪼 실로 말레스 쪼 강에 되게 이나요 세 노노는 지세 냠바르지 다 배도 매베 세 강에 되게 요아르
So then, why did we need to make this emphasis that the happiness arises from those positive mental qualities that we develop in the mind? Well, because the same is true of our problems. In terms of the problems, the difficulties, or unhappiness that we encounter, we are often thinking that those are coming from outer conditions, but we understand that actually, mainly, those problems, those unhappinesses, they are coming from an inner cause, from an inner cause of unwholesome or negative minds.
어다 네츠 조데 노르 요 아이자 아니 어다 송지 조시 비거든 시고 도마 관계가 아니 센지 강에 레레 바꿔야 나요 녀보 할 레비더니 보 부서 두번 뭐뭐 어찌 말해 니 말해 뭐 보여 뭐 보수 요 알아스
So, recognizing this, that all of these inner problems, they came from something inside the mind, from causes inside the minds, then the Buddhas and the Bodhisattvas, all those holy beings, they proposed in terms of these unwholesome minds, the antidotes we needed to cultivate in order to solve that problem. And not just one antidote, many antidotes for all of the different types of unwholesome minds.
어다 드리 이자 드리 나도 내시 자야 돼 솔로가 찍이 돈에 돈에 마치 찌는 내시 자야 돼다 센지 내시 피 강가 대야게 내면 나와 강에 요도 파과야게 다파 쪼온다고 잡온다고 티가 내서
So then, in terms of the verse or the shloka that we will explain today, it relates to this because it is like a key by which we can activate all of those inner conditions for mental happiness, for lasting happiness. And similarly, it is like a king of antidotes to be able to address all of the unhappiness or the suffering within the mind.
어다 쪼쪼 되는 되는 소지 쪼 된데 론이 등 가자 거는 전벌인데 페네 아니 대진 대완 주와 스텐 주가 따와 가 첨보지 안 속강에 강가 체주 간디스 이나 내 봐서야 또뭐또뭐 소지 그 수발에스
Conde, ¿candes me pasó ya?
야 강에 체주
Oh,
간디지 이나 강가 내 봐서야 돼 아니 론이 등 가자 거는 손지가 또뭐 수발아 왔
So then, of course, we also know that Buddha Shakyamuni, he appeared in this world approximately 2,500 years ago. And in terms of what he was teaching, it was all of these very manifold methods in order to be able to get rid of our problems. And one of the most important of these was this teaching on dependent arising or dependent origination.
어다 드리숄로 같이 돼 아닌 게 뭘로 돼 손진이 바다 무슨 거 아래 손진이 바로와 어 경계 로마 아야 내와 그수 아니 어다 숄로 같이 있으마 대년에 때네 뒤돈이 돼 시작이 있어
So the verse that Geshe-la would like to share with you, and he would like to explain a little bit about for you today, is a verse from a student of a being who is often known as the second Buddha, Nagarjuna. And this particular verse was written by a student of Nagarjuna named Aryadeva.
어 다치 데크 슐로가치 간디스레세나 대진데와 주마코 토나 뜨면 주마죠 디시르 메와끈 인다 돈데 코나니야 바샤
So Geshe-la is reading the verse from Aryadeva's 400 in Tibetan. So I will give you the English translation. When all dependent arisings are seen, confusion or ignorance will not occur. Thus, every effort that has been made here to explain this subject. So in terms of this verse that was shared by the author here, Geshe-la said that this is in fact an idea which is put forth by many of the other holy beings such as Nagarjuna and many others as well. So what is being shared here in this first line, when dependent arising is seen, confusion or ignorance will not occur? Well, we understand that when we are able to develop an understanding of this dependent arising, it is able to address the root of all problems. It is able to address the sort of source of all problems, which is this ignorance grasping at the self. So then generally we could say that the teachings give us antidotes, specific antidotes for all of the afflictions, such as attachment, such as aversion, and so forth. But what is being stated here is that if one is able to understand this dependent arising, bring forth an understanding of this dependent arising, then one is able to directly counteract the root of all of the afflictions, which is ignorance. And then by being able to counteract the root of all of the afflictions, then all the other branch afflictions, because we attack that root, they will be able to be dissipated. So then the next two lines, thus every effort has been made here to explain this subject. So this means that when one puts effort into understanding dependent arising, that when one forcefully attempts to engage with dependent arising, then Sorry, I misunderstood. So therefore, because dependent arising has all of these benefits and can get rid of this confusion, then we should direct all of our efforts, all of our striving to comprehend that. So when we first hear this as beginners, it might seem that it is a little bit difficult or not so easy to understand, but we shouldn't get discouraged and we shouldn't set it aside, because if we engage with it just a little bit, there are definitely things here that we as beginners can use.
Ota peje kandis to gares na ni to ayares ramba tombo. Ani tenju 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 se atela jendri tenju tenen to bi tenju se yawa ni she ni ge to nen tenen garos kange teke serji lpa tak ayares.
So how can we use this teaching as beginners? Well, first we need to think about the types of dependent arising. So we can think about the first type of dependent arising, the dependent arising of cause and effect, as well as the second type of dependent arising, the dependent arising of dependent designation. And if we familiarize ourselves then as a beginner, we can apply these as a way to solve various problems or difficulties.
Mm-hmm.
So in terms of an easy way to explain this first kind of dependent arising, which is that dependent arising of cause and effect, then we should understand that any suffering or discomfort or of body or mind, this has a cause. And its cause was affliction, actions, but ultimately driven by affliction. So the cause is affliction or unwholesome minds.
Mutone, Selki womebi toachi, Kaze deva yina, de kangalu kondroti in divas.
So we can see that, for example, if we have an instance where anger arises in the mind, then after arising that anger, however long we have a mind of unhappiness or suffering that kind of lasts after that, we see that ultimately the cause of that suffering or unhappiness was the arising of that mind of anger, yeah? So this is a very clear example of a dependent arising of cause and effect. There's nothing difficult here except maybe our lack of familiarity with the name. We see that in terms of the cause of that period of unhappiness or that unhappy mind, it was this cause of anger, right? So the dependent arising shows us that if we don't want to experience that resultant unhappiness, then we need to eliminate the cause of anger. Similarly, to give another example, if we take the example of love, we can see that love, in terms of a relationship of cause and effect, that if we are able to bring stable love forward within the mind, then after we bring that forth, then the mind will experience a state of a peace and happiness. This is very clear. So we understand then, from the point of view of this dependent arising relationship, if we want a lasting and stable happiness, not just for ourselves, but also for others, our family, and so forth, then we want to bring forth that mind of love, right? That is a way to achieve it. And we have a little bit of that mind in our love right now, but what we want to do is try to cultivate it in a stable and lasting way.
Oh, that the Jindit and Jugatuna Legacy to Lila Wundu was, or Matumbokan, Tombikan and Zopechetuna,
So here is a way that we can engage with this dependent arising of cause and effect as a beginner. This is not something that is beyond us, it is something that we definitely can do, and it is definitely something that if we apply ourselves, we will get some benefit from. And then as compared to that first kind of dependent arising, the second kind of dependent arising, the dependent arising of dependent designation, it is even more subtle. It is even more profound, you could say. So how can we use this second type, the dependent arising of dependent designation? Well, first of all, we can understand that within our mind, inside of ourselves, we have many different seeds or imprints. And then when these seeds or imprints meet an outer condition, an object or a person, that gives rise to our attachment, that gives rise to our aversion, then those seeds are activated and we see that appearance as if it is something that is really existing in the way it appears.
Oh, that you could do. Mambo chira tene tabiga pene tsu chujuji yarwas maro su ti tola ha leve jasha gachase pa rapochi mitene meba jil hapo zon rukuyo arayis, chapa shia sagayo, kundro shia sagayo.
But what we need to understand here in regards to our object of anger or aversion, but also in regards to our object of attachment, is that that object or that person, they are a result of many causes and conditions coming together. And when we're angry or attached, the appearance of that object, 90% of it is an exaggeration that is arising from our side.
Oda tombo sozo ge sege pachi zo sa sumas. Te zon ni na da chin nuwa zma chile yung yu ares.
So because of the role that our mind had in exaggerating or creating that appearance, but it seems that because of the appearance that it is coming from the side of the object.
Oda tani nga ru su nuwa nuji ten zo. Zma nuji ti ji san ro ni la.
Yeah.
Tani mata ni nga ru su oda kange ti ten yung yu ares.
So what happens here is that we think, we don't see our role in it, so we think that the object is existing in the way that it appears to us, then we grasp at that as a reality that the object exists in the way it appears to us, and then our actions follow that false assumption, and then we run into all of those problems or difficulties. So this is part of what dependent designation is telling us, that we have this appearance of that object, right, that gave rise to our attachment or aversion, but so much of that appearance is something that is created from us, from our own mind, but we're tricked by the appearance and we don't see that, our role in it. But if we use wisdom to investigate that appearance, and then we can comprehend our role in exaggerating it or creating it, then definitely, 100%, we can reduce the afflictions that are arising due to that appearance.
Oh, ta yek koro yung, chapa shi sa yek kundo shi sa yek koro yung, nika ge jiche, chashi.
Chashi.
Oh, ta.
So if we use this to think in terms of that object of our attachment or aversion, that this is just a temporary appearance arising due to various parts and factors, then because of that dependent designation, gonda teni tapi tenju hakuna dene. So if we see the role of dependent designation and that it is just a coming together of various causes and conditions, then we can use this wisdom to directly undermine the afflictions that are arising connected with that. So if we apply the dependent arising, specifically the dependent arising of dependent designation in this way, then of course a full understanding of emptiness, that is something that comes later. But if we apply just a little bit of this understanding, then definitely we can come to improvement and we can come to some
benefit.
So because this dependent arising, this wisdom of dependent arising is said to be one of the kings of wisdoms, then definitely if we try to use and apply this wisdom, we will come to great profit and benefit and also happiness.
Oh.
Thank you very much, Tashi Dele. We shall end it here.